Hey everyone, it's Albert Flynn DeSilver here, checking in from my living room. As you may or may not know, I'm the author of Writing as a Path to Awakening from Sounds to, and the memoir Beamish Boy. And I am just checking in to say hello. And I hope this message finds you and your family staying safe and healthy. And I hope also that you have heard about the free offerings. Every Wednesday, I'm doing a meditation class, and every Friday, I'm doing a free writing and journaling class. And you are welcome to join us on Zoom. I'm sending out the links every week through the email. So you are probably, if you're watching this, you're probably on the email list. If you're not, you can jump on and get a free book in the process. And so today, what I wanted to do in this video is share with you three things that I'm doing right now to kind of change my whole vision and worldview, to stay engaged, to stay uplifted, to stay inspired, and to keep moving forward. And the first thing is, the primary thing, is support the community. I want to support you with as much free classes and as many free sessions and workshops and whatever I can do. I'm giving away the book right now for pretty much for free. All I need is just to cover the cost of shipping. But you can get that doing these free classes every week. Four free classes every week. I'm doing two classes through a yoga studio here in Northern California, in Berkeley, California. Plus I'm doing two on my own. So there's a lot of free content out there for you to help support you, to uplift you. So that's the first thing I'm doing. The second thing I'm doing is I am studying and I am learning. I'm studying my writing, I just submitted a new book proposal. So I've been reviewing my book proposal, the outlines and formats. I've been just reading novels and studying novels, rereading, going back and rereading. I have a novel project in process. So there's that. But really, more than anything, what I'm doing now is figuring out, like, how can I nourish my creativity in a bigger context, from broader perspective, so that it's not just about writing, it's not just about the creativity and sort of this fun thing that we like to do. But how is this writing, how can that writing impact people in a real way? And I want you to think about this in your own life. How is your creativity impacting you? Or what is the potential for your message to get out in the world and have a larger impact? That's what writing is all about. It's communication. Communicating your message, your powerful experiences with the world in a big way. So that's why it's right now is such an important, powerful time. So the third thing I'm doing is I'm actually getting coaching. I'm doing some training on where I don't have the skills, like whether that's in online stuff and technology, building some business skills, some gaps in my writing and creativity stuff. So I'm getting some coaching. I'm staying engaged. I'm learning, continuing to get support. It's so, so important to be engaged right now and to keep moving forward in this time. And I know it's uncertain, I know it feels a little edgy, but these are the times that make a huge difference. Let me just tell you a couple stories. Really quick, when I'm thinking back to like my entire working life and those times when things really shifted, when things really became more abundant and uplifted in my life experience. And the weird thing is it was always during economic downturns and economic uncertainty. So I think back to the year 1999, the year 2000, right around when, and this is early part of my working life, and there was a huge dot-com bust, and the economy tanked and the stock market tanked. And what did I do? I was training, I was studying, and I was hard at work being a poet, and then studying to be a teacher. And to figure out how could I share this message with kids, in my case. I was really interested in working with kids and learning how to be an effective teacher and bringing my love of poetry, my passion to poetry, to kids. And so I started training with the Poets in the Schools program in California. And what happened was there was so much support for creativity in the schools. People were giving so many donations that our parent teacher organizations during this time actually had like this abundance of money to support visiting poets in the schools. So I was getting larger and larger contracts right around 2000, 2001, right around 9/11, when we were just devastated as a country. And there was all this uncertainty, economic uncertainty, fear, etc. And I was just like so engaged. I too, of course, was fearful, but I was also so engaged with poetry and seeing, feeling poetry as a healing thing for kids to express themselves in this time, to get some of that emotional energy and confusion out on the page. And it was so, so powerful. And so I was getting paid $50 an hour to teach poetry in the schools. It was incredible. And then not too long after that, excuse me, bless me, I was making $60 an hour. And then the next year it was $75 an hour. And then it was $85 an hour. And it was like, what? It was so confusing because this was a time of economic uncertainty. And yet for me, it was somehow becoming a time of creative and economic abundance. And so much of that had to do with mindset and passion and practice. And so this is what's really incredible and important right now for you to engage deeply in your passion and your practice. Now I think to the next economic meltdown. So fast forward to 2007, and I'm in transition. I'm transitioning out of teaching poetry in the schools, which I've been doing for many, many years. And my wife is transitioning out of working with really intensive mental health patients. And we had a new property that we had to pay for. And, you know, the economic everything had been on the upswing up until 2005, 2006, and real estate was going crazy. So we bought a property and we invested heavily in this property, everything that we owned. And then, of course, 2007 happened. And we were having this house built and we didn't know how we were going to pay for it. And the mortgage was going to come due in 2008. What did we do? We studied, we went to work. I started studying business and money and economics and how to just like take it to that next level economically so that we were able to live in this house. This house is the product of that. And we ended up buying into a franchise organization, a poet and a social worker going into business. I don't know how this worked. In the worst economic recession since the Great Depression, I'm pretty sure that's how it was characterized. Massive unemployment, massive uncertainty. We went to work, we studied, and we bought into this home care company, and it just took off. 2007, 2008, 2009, this turned into, in 2 years, was just shy of $1 million company, profitable. And we were helping people in the community. It was a caregiving agency. And we learned and we studied and we went to seminars. And all during this time, we just kept investing, and staying engaged. So this, and here we are in the, this is probably one of the larger economic challenges of our time. And this is the time. This is your time to get to work, to study, to engage, to think creatively, to use your writing skills and your creativity and your communication, to take your life to that next level. And this is a huge opportunity, and I want to support you in that journey, which is why I am offering right now a new coaching program, an affordable, accessible coaching program. I've created this for you. I've worked a lot with people one-on-one, but my time is limited. It's not that accessible, it's expensive. And so I wanted to offer a low-cost coaching program, which provides the same support, I mean, not quite exactly the same, but a lot of the same support, and in some ways, more support, because what we're gonna do is, not only are we gonna have the accountability, the support and encouragement, but it's gonna be in community. So in addition to being one-on-one, I'm gonna be, of course, teaching, but we're also gonna include case studies. And so each session will have people who are working on a book proposal, who are working on a novel, who are working on ways of getting their work out in the world, are dealing with editing challenges, whatever it is. Each week, we're gonna have somebody as a case study, and I'm gonna do some live coaching with them for the benefit of the community. And so even if you're not working on a book proposal, you're gonna get something out of it that week. Then eventually we'll come to you and we will work on your particular project. And we'll process that and we'll do Q&A and we'll have a whole series of resources devoted to that particular topic for that particular week. So there will be accountability, there will be declarations, there will be support. And you'll also have the added gift of community. You'll be able to draw on each other and share information and ideas and resources. I do not know it all. And so it's kind of this way that we come together collectively. And so I wanted to put that out there, to offer this as an option to support you during this time, to take your writing, your creativity, your ideas to that next level through a group coaching program that is affordable, that is accessible in this time. So all you have to do is go ahead and click the link below. You can reserve your spot. This is all going to happen on Zoom starting in mid-April. I'm going to say April 15th on this video, but it might change, so stay tuned. And if you have questions, feel free to shoot me an email, owlassistant@gmail.com. Email will be down below as well. But I'm going to limit this to no more than 30 people in this class. I'd like to keep it smaller, but there's probably gonna be a lot of demand. So go ahead and reserve your spot now, click the link, sign up, and if you have questions, shoot us an email. Send me an email, happy to communicate with you. Tell me about what your project is, what you're looking to get out of this kind of a group coaching program. And thank you always for listening. Until next time, live well, love well, and write well, and we will be in touch really soon.